up against the red, white, and blue banner is that of Keith Handling. He's a retired Special Forces Lieutenant Colonel. He has over 4,000 parachute jumps. And our third jumper today is that of Army spouse Yvette Walter. She has over 2,400 jumps to her credit. And now, ladies and gentlemen, if you are within the sound of my voice and you are able, if you would, please stand, remove your caps, and come to attention as we welcome the Ladies for Liberty in the singing of our yourself with like-minded enthusiastic people, you don't even need an airplane to be a part. Aerobatics is a sport driven by passion, skill, and hard work. And while many members love the sport, even if they don't, I can see myself everyone's achievements in aerobatics, not just those who compete.
Thank you. Piper Ennis Scott was watching all these Piper guns, military Piper guns in the province of Telegraph.
Oh, this is crazy. You're being a chair. Woohoo! The C-47 was a key weapon to winning the war. Along with the brave crew members that operated this aircraft, it was our air mobility workhorse during World War II for many years following. Beyond transporting troops like you see today, it represented a lifeline to thousands. It delivered supplies to our surrounding troops in the storm.
Jetmaster has already given his 1 minute warning. Right now, adrenaline is starting to surge even for these reenactors. But can you imagine what it was like on D-Day, June of 1944, in the dark, jumping into enemy territory? This is just a taste of what happened in World War II.
Have this airplane surrounded by over 800 other aircraft just like the U.S.
Jumpers away.
so you can tell by the intakes to say Super Hornet.
Yeah.
I thought Legacy.
Victory Aircraft in the Toronto area.
Or I think it's a growler, actually. And I remember there was a growler there.
Initially, I was asking if they got that, whether we can finish by this time.